Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at some iMovie basics. So we're using iMovie version 10. The most basic thing that you can do with iMovie is to take several clips, say take them with your phone or your camera, and string them together to create one video that you can then share. So to do this, you want to create a new iMovie project. First, you want to go make sure you're using the library, not theater mode of iMovie. So I want to get some video clips into my iMovie library. And the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to use the import button here, and then I'm going to browse to find these videos. And I've got a set right here. I'm going to select them all and hit import all. And it will bring these then into my library. And I have a sample event here called samples. And it's put them all in there. It's going to take a few minutes and it will render them all so I can see them here below. Now at this point I can move my cursor through these video clips here below, and I can see at the top preview area the video, so I can scrub around in them. I can also click in one, and you can see I place the timeline there, and I can do that anywhere in any of these videos. And then I could also drag and select an area. And when I select an area like that, or double click to select the entire thing, I can already go to File and share this out as a file or to different services. So I can just share this one clip without ever actually creating an iMovie project. But if I want to put some clips together, I'm going to want to create a project. So I'm going to go to File, New Movie, which will create a new movie project. I'm going to choose No Theme here and Create, and I'm going to create one called My Movie, and I'm just going to stick it here inside of the iMovie library inside of samples, which is already created there. And now everything's going to change, and I can see my clips here are on the upper left. I could see a timeline for my current project here at the bottom, and I could see the preview area has moved over to the right. And I could still scrub around inside of the clips here inside of the samples event to see different portions of it. I can grab a portion or double click to grab an entire clip. Now to combine several clips, what I want to do is just select an area and then more double click to select the entire clip and drag it down here below. So I can select this other clip here, and I can either put it before the first one and we'll insert it there, or I could stick it after. I'm going to stick it after there, and now I've got one clip following the other. So you can do all this a little bit better if you know how to control what you're seeing. For instance, here for the clips, I can decide to click here and change the clip size so I can maybe see a little clearer what's there or see more of what's there. I'd also change the zoom to see how close I zoom in, and I could go to all, which basically puts every clip in a single image here, no matter how long it is. I can show waveforms or not. So I could do a similar thing here below. I can show and hide the waveforms. I can change the clip size. I can zoom in or out so I can fit more here on the timeline. See these clips here. I'll make it easier, say, when I add my next clip to the end. I can see all three together. So now that I've put together three clips here, I can export them using the share function. So I can hit the share button right here, and there are various different things I can share directly to. I'm going to go and share it out to a file, and I can select the size here, and I can go down in size, but I can't go up in size. These are all 720p videos. I can't create a video with more detail than exists in the clips, of course. So I'll leave it at that, and I'm also going to check or uncheck the add to theater check mark there. Let's move that for now and hit next, and it'll ask me for a file name. So I'm going to save it as My Movie, placing the one that's already there. It'll export out, and you'll see a progress button right here that basically shows you the progress that's making for the export, and you can click on it and you can see some details from that progress. When it's done, it opens up QuickTime Player automatically with the video in it. It also gives me a notification here. So I've got the video now exported into a file. Another way to share is to go to Theater, and what it'll do then is it will take you to the iMovie Theater, and it's going to place several versions different sizes in here, and also going to upload them to iCloud. So it'll take a little while for it to complete. So once it's done, not only is it saved here locally as a finished project, but it's also synced to iCloud, so I should see it on my other machines in iTunes Theater as well. I've got some options here that I could remove it from iCloud, but it will remain here on the local machine. You can even add regular clips to iTunes Theater. So let me close the project here, and then I could select a clip like this one, and I can go to File, Share, or hit the Share button here and share just that clip to iTunes Theater, so then it would sync across my machines using iCloud.